Hello. The week ahead promises some very high temperatures, potentially record-breaking conditions. Across some parts of the UK, temperatures likely to get into the mid-30s. Not everywhere going to see those temperatures, but most places will at least be significantly above average. And pretty much everywhere, one thing you'll notice, the nights are uncomfortable. Humid conditions persisting through the nights, and that combination of humidity and high temperatures means there's the real threat of some thunderstorms too. So plenty to talk about. What's going on? Let's take a look at the big picture. A classic scenario, really, with high pressure hanging on across the UK, low pressure trying to squeeze in, and as a result, hot air getting sucked up from France and Spain. This little feature will provide some thunderstorms late on Tuesday and into Wednesday. But for most of Tuesday, it's dry and fine for most parts. Could start a bit misty, and we do still have a weather front bringing some rain across the Northern Isles and the Western Isles, but even that should peter out. The mist and low cloud that we start off with fade away, and so for the vast majority, Tuesday is sunny and hot. Temperatures widely across central and eastern areas over 30 Celsius, 34 likely in and around London. Even further north, where it could stay fairly cloudy in the far northwest, we're looking at 20 Celsius, and parts of the Murray coastline could reach 27 Celsius, so warmer here compared to Monday. Some coasts will be a little bit cooler, but yes, temperatures definitely on the rise and staying high through Tuesday evening. That's when this little feature we saw earlier will be pushing northwards, bringing some thunderstorms. You may get woken up by a flash of lightning or a rumble of thunder. There'll be some downpours too. That's if you can sleep at all, because temperatures will be staying really high through Tuesday evening into Wednesday morning. We're likely to start Wednesday morning with temperatures in the high teens or low 20s, and some places may not drop below, say, 22 or 23 degrees Celsius. There'll still be some thundery showers across the northeast at first on Wednesday, maybe across East Anglia and the southeast too, but they tend to clear away. And so for most Wednesday, again, dry. A bit more cloud in the west, misty, murky conditions around some coasts. Again, it'll be eastern areas that see the highest temperatures on Wednesday, again, over 30 degrees. 35 is possible in East Anglia. With a bit more cloud in the west, it won't be as hot on Wednesday compared to Tuesday, but the heat hasn't gone away for good, far from it. This next low pressure just ebbing in wafts up some even hotter air during Wednesday night and into Thursday. And Thursday, we're likely to see the peak of the temperatures through this week. That is when we could easily get temperatures up to 35, 36, maybe even 37 degrees Celsius. If we get to 37, that'll be the record for July ever recorded across the UK. It's another hot one then, basically, on Thursday. But it will be, again, hot and sunny everywhere. More of a breeze blowing in the west with more clouds spilling in here. An increasing chance of seeing some thundery showers break out on Thursday as well. Many will start dry and sunny, but here is that cloud spilling in. Showery rain, certainly for Northern Ireland. We could see some thunderstorms breaking out elsewhere. Now, as always with summer thunderstorms, they'll be very hit and miss. Some places catching torrential downpours, whereas just a few miles away, it stays dry. For the details about Thursday and those thunderstorms, make sure you stay tuned to the forecast, because things will be swapping around a little bit through this week. By Thursday night, that low pressure is a bit closer in, and the weather front actually tries to push its way across the UK, trying to sweep away the heat and humidity. So notice it's quite a bit cooler in the west on Friday, with, again, a fair bit of cloud and some showers. Again, on that cold front, there could be some thundery downpours. It all depends on the exact mixture of the heat, humidity, and the moisture too. But it won't be as hot, I don't think, on Friday if that weather front moves in. But still, temperatures will be significantly above average in the east. 25, 26 is possible, whereas by Friday in the west, we're back much closer to average, high teens or low 20s. And then into the weekend, another area of low pressure arrives. And this one, instead of ushering up some hot air, will bring, well, more typical Atlantic air in, but also the potential for some showers. That's a long way off, though. Before we get there, plenty of hot weather to contend with over the next few days. Make sure you stay up to date with the very latest. Best way to do that is to follow us on social media.